tunes and Ferris wheels, the dizzy dancing where you feel. When every fairy tale comes real, I've looked at love that way, and now it's just another show. You leave them laughing when you go. Yourself away. I've looked at love from both sides now. Give and take and steal somehow. It's love's illusions I recall. I really don't know love at all. Tears and fears and to say I love you right out loud. Dreams and schemes and circus crowds, I've looked at life that way, and now old friends are acting strange. They shake their heads and say I've changed. Well, something's lost, but something's gained.
Much. You are such a great audience. I am so thrilled to have you here tonight. Among the greatest writers and the greatest spirits of this whole past, I don't know, 50, 40 years, was a writer who one of the things about him that I loved so much is that he was an optimist. His dad was a drummer, and we always got along, talked about growing up in the musical life, because my dad had a radio show, started in Seattle, had a show here in L.A. for many years, and being a kid like Arla was, you know, the children of musicians, is really a great gift. And Harry Chapin was an optimist because he started an organization called World Hunger Year. He thought he could solve world hunger in a year, and we're still at it, but he's up in heaven somewhere, I think, still thinking up the best lines. My child arrived just the other day. He came to the world in the usual way, but there were planes to catch, bills to pay. He learned to walk while I was away, and he was talking for I knew it, and as he grew, he said, I'm gonna be like you, Dad. You know I'm gonna be like you, you know it, don't you? And the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon, little boy blue and the man in the moon. Where you coming home, I don't know when. We'll get together then, son. You know we'll have a good time.